In the spring of 1970, International Harvester started running ads in farm magazines announcing the Gold Demonstrator tractor sales promotion. And Gold tractors started showing up on dealers' lots. Hi, I'm Randy Van Wy, and I'd like to explain the Gold Demonstrator tractor sales promotion. A sales promotion, that's exactly what it was. It was IH's attempt to sell more tractors. IH had produced the hydro transmission for tractors a few years back already and put it in the 656 and 544. And more recently, they built a heavier one for the 826 and 1026. But farmers were still skeptical. Would that really stand up under my work conditions? Well, IH thought if they could get farmers using those tractors on their farms, they would sell more tractors. That was the first and the main reason for the Gold Demonstrator program. But they had a second reason. It was to help clear dealers' lots of the 56 series tractors, because the 66 series tractors were due out the following year. The five models that were involved in the Gold Demonstrator program were the 544, only in the hydro, the 656, only in the hydro. Now the 826 was available in the hydro and in the gear drive. The 1026 was only produced in the hydro version, and the big 1456 was only produced in the gear drive. So here's how it worked. In 1970, the only year they had the Gold Demonstrator program, there was approximately 15 to maybe 1600 independent IH dealers in the country at that time. And IH would allow each one of them to order one Gold Demonstrator for the program. Now you gotta remember, these were independent dealers. They were spending their own money. So not all of them participated. Some of them, I guess, just didn't want that ugly gold tractor sitting around on their lots. Well, the idea was when the gold tractor would arrive at the dealership, they were supposed to let as many customers use that tractor on their farms as possible throughout the entire season. At the end of the season, get that tractor back into the dealership, paint original IH red over top of that gold paint, and sell the tractor at a discount. Well, at IH, at the manufacturing plant, when a purchase order would arrive for a Gold Demonstrator, they simply selected at random one of the tractors coming down the line of that particular model, took the sheet metal and sent it out to a local body shop for the gold paint, and then reassembled everything at the end of the line. Now, the serial numbers were never tracked, as far as we know, on these Gold Demonstrators. At least, if they were, that list was lost at the time of the acquisition by Tenneco in 1984. But we do know that most of the Gold Demonstrators were produced during the months of August, September, and October of 1970. So the serial numbers are going to be in that middle to three-quarter range of the serial number list of that particular year. So why are Gold Demonstrators collectible? Well, if there was 1,500 dealers in the country at that time, and not all of them participated, we can safely assume then there was possibly 1,000 Gold Demonstrators manufactured. But that was 50 years ago. Some of them have already hit the salvage yards, and some may never be found. So we can assume then that there's approximately 700, maybe 750 Gold Demonstrators, authentic Gold Demonstrators, out in the country identified. Out of the millions of tractors in this country, 700 is a very rare number. And Gold Demonstrators are very collectible. Well, you ask, how would I find one that's possibly undiscovered? Well, that red paint that the dealers put over top of the gold is 50 years old, and it's starting to fade. So look for that gold paint coming out from underneath that red. Check around the edges and the corners. That's the first place it'll show up. Another thing is the dealers were notorious for painting the outside of the hoods, but very seldom did they paint underneath the hoods. So check underneath the hoods for gold paint as well. The cowling around the dash and the steering post and the gauges is always painted black on a Gold Demonstrator. And on a utility Gold Demonstrator, it's even painted black on that flat panel underneath the steering column all the way down to the deck. On a restored Gold Demonstrator, before and after pictures become extremely important. There are people that have taken a regular red 1970 tractor and painted it gold just to try and make a few extra bucks. Pirating a Gold Demonstrator cheapens the authenticity and history of IH, and it trashes the pride of ownership. I'd be very skeptical of any restored Gold Demonstrator that doesn't have the before and after picture history. International Harvester at one time was the third largest corporation in the world, and farm equipment was its core foundation. The Gold Demonstrator tractor sales promotion is just one example of International's leadership in farm equipment. Owning a Gold Demonstrator is owning a piece of IH history. Own it with pride. Own it with respect. Own a Gold Demonstrator and enjoy.
the flower, chugging, lugging, lugging 5 miles an hour. I'm the international harvester. The flower, chugga lugga lugging 5 miles an hour. I'm an international harvester.
God looked down on his planned paradise and said, I need a caretaker. So God made a farmer. God said, I need somebody willing to get up before dawn, milk cows, work all day in the fields, milk cows again, eat supper, then go to town and stay past midnight at a meeting of the school board. So God made a farmer. I need somebody with arms strong enough to wrestle a calf and yet gentle enough to deliver his own grandchild. Somebody to call hogs, tame cantankerous machinery, come home hungry, have to wait lunch until his wife's done feeding visiting ladies, then tell the ladies to be sure and come back real soon and mean it. So God made a farmer. God said, I need somebody willing to sit up all night with a newborn colt and watch it die, then dry his eyes and say, maybe next year. I need somebody who can shape an axe handle from a persimmon sprout, shoe a horse with a hunk of car tire, who can make harness out of hay, wire, feed sacks, and shoe scraps, who planting time and harvest season will finish his 40-hour week by Tuesday noon, and then pain in from tractor back put in another 72 hours. So God made a farmer. God had to have somebody willing to ride the ruts at double speed to get the hay in ahead of the rain clouds and yet stop in midfield and race to help when he sees the first smoke from a neighbor's place. So God made a farmer. God said, I need somebody strong enough to clear trees and heave bales, yet gentle enough to yean lambs and wean pigs and tend the pink-combed pullets, who will stop his mower for an hour to splint the broken leg of a meadowlark. So God made a farmer. It had to be somebody who'd plow deep and straight and not cut corners, somebody to seed, weed, feed, breed, and rake, and disc, and plow, and plant, and tie the fleece, and strain the milk, and replenish the self-feeder, and finish a hard week's work with a 5 mile drive to church. Somebody who'd bail a family together with the soft, strong bonds of sharing. Who would laugh and then sigh and then reply with smiling eyes when his son says that he wants to spend his life doing what dad does. So God made a farmer.
Tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. The men who died, who gave that right to me, and I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, where there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
In 1970, International Harvester created a sales promotion of gold-painted tractors. It promoted small utility tractors for the livestock producer, the high-utility tractors for the tobacco farmer, and the powerful row crop tractors that tilled the corn and soybean fields. The IH Gold Demonstrator tractor sales promotion symbolizes the golden era of booming agricultural expansion. It also symbolizes the golden era of family farming and small rural town America. IH was a leader in the golden era, economically driven by the development and expansion of agriculture all across America. Farm production not only fueled the economy of farms, but also the rural communities and the nation. The golden era was focused on a close family lifestyle. Small town farming communities built schools and churches that created a family and community atmosphere that bonded us together. While growing up in a small community, we developed our own styles of speech, customs, values, and foods. We developed a similar way of looking at the world that we would be willing to fight for and even die for if we were asked. We developed these community values by listening to our elders discussing the world around the coffee table, by listening to the local radio station and watching our peers conduct themselves at ball games, meetings, and business dealings. We developed a respect for God and country by saying the Pledge of Allegiance every morning in school, by removing our hats at ball games during the Star Spangled Banner, and reading "In God We Trust" on a $20 bill. We would get a chill running down our back while watching films of soldiers raise Old Glory on Iwo Jima and feel a lump in our throat at the planting of Stars and Stripes on the moon. Growing up in small town America taught us morals and responsibility. It taught us to work, trust, and care for one another. It gave us basic skills to develop careers, lead organizations, build companies, and strengthen government by following the examples of our parents and other community leaders. This collection of IH Gold Demonstrator tractors is our salute to International Harvester and the hard-working families of the golden era. These families took the risks, did the work, and held each other accountable on our farms, in our factories, and in our small towns. They built not only the greatest economy in the world, but also the most desirable place to live and raise a family, the United States of America. God bless the USA.
Sun over by the gate, Lordy, here she comes with a basket full of chicken and a big cold jug of sweet tea. Well, I make a little room and she climbs on up. I open up a throttle and stir a little dust. Just look at her face, she ain't a fooling me. She thinks my tractor's sexy, it really turns her on. She's always staring at me while I'm chugging along. She likes the way it's pulling while we're tilling up the land. She's even kind of crazy about my farmer's tan. She's the only one who really understands what gets me. Thinks my tractor's sexy. We ride back and forth till we run out of light. Take it to the barn, put it up for the night. Climb up in the loft, sit and talk with the radio on. She says she's got a dream and I ask what it is. She wants a little farm and a yard full of kids, and one more teeny weeny ride before I take her home. She thinks my tractor's sexy, it really turns her on. She's always staring at me while I'm chugging along. My tractor's sexy. Well, she ain't into cars or pickup trucks, but if it runs like a deer, man, her eyes light up. She thinks my tractor's sexy. It really turns her on. She's always staring at me while I'm chugging. She likes the way it's pulling while we're tilling up her land. She's even kind of crazy about my farmer's tan. She's the only one who really understands what gets me. She thinks my tractor's sexy. She thinks my tractor's sexy. She thinks my tractor's sexy.